Hi students, Mrs. McGee. This week we're going to be making the Polaroid painting. So Polaroids were, for those of you who don't know, how you could take pictures before cell phones, before digital cameras. It was a camera where you would snap the photo and it would print the picture right away. It had a border and then they always had like a big white spot on the bottom where you could tell right what you were taking a picture of, so you could document what you were doing. So we're going to take a kind of spin on that and paint or draw, color in your own Polaroid, but by doing it manually instead of with a camera. I'd like you guys to read the letter I wrote you. I'm not going to necessarily talk about it here, but I'm really, really sad about not seeing you guys for the rest of the year. It's really hard knowing that you guys are eighth graders and I won't get to see you and I won't get to teach you again in person, but please just read the letter I wrote you. Know that I loved this year and it's really sad and upsetting to not be able to go back and finish it the year with you in school, but we are gonna make the best of it here and I really can't wait to see your work that you guys do with me for the next 8 weeks together. But please keep your spirits up. Please email me if you ever need anything. And let's make some fun projects for the next 8 weeks. And I hope that you enjoy this project. So hope you had a good April vacation and let's get started. So you wanna make sure that you choose something that's like a landscape, but it can be a landscape of anything. It can be not necessarily a landscape, I guess a scene. You can do a scene from your bedroom. You can do a scene from your rear window, like a scene that you've been seeing over and over for the past 2 months, or you can do your favorite photograph that you took. You can do any kind of scene, but you want it to be a scene. People can be in it, objects can be in it. It can just be nature. It can be a scene maybe that you make up in your head. It's really gonna be up to you. So I'm gonna show you the picture that I chose. This is a photograph that I took when I was in Arizona. We were up in a hot air balloon and there was another one in the sky next to us. So this is gonna be the image that I paint as a Polaroid. So I'm going to show you how you start and how you do that now. And I hope that you enjoy this demo and I will see yours in a little bit. All right, bye.
Together, 'cause we don't know. nice and loose and loose. Shake it, shake it, baby doll. Shake it on the floor. Get on the floor. Shake it like a polaroid. You know what to do, y'all. Sugar, shake it. You know what to do. Sugar, shake it, shake it.
Watched a quick video, well, not super quick, but quick video of me doing the hot air balloon. Obviously, I would probably put a little more detail into it, but I'm just trying to do it quickly so you guys can get the idea. So you always walk work back to front. So you want to make sure you paint whatever is furthest back. So if you're doing a landscape, you would paint whatever is furthest back. That's most likely the sky. If you're doing a scene, you just want to look into the picture and think of what is the furthest thing back. So you paint front back to front. So you paint the furthest thing back, then you paint the middle ground, and then you would paint what's in the foreground, okay? So there are three different areas in a scene: background, middle ground, foreground. And you paint it that way. So you paint background, middle ground, foreground. I'm gonna show you this is the finished piece. So when you are done with it, you cut it out and you have your edges. So this is what a Polaroid picture used to look like. And then down here, you can kind of write what it is. So you document it. And this would be your finished piece. I would love for you to upload them to me, and that would be awesome. So, if you can see back here, there's my little dog. Hey, Boat. Hey, come here, Bodie. Not really little, but this is Bodie. He's 5, and he's just waiting to go out right now. But he's always down here in my art studio doing the videoing with me. I guess he just likes to be in this room. But I hope you guys are good, and I hope to see all of your work passed in. Try to get it in on time. And I will be seeing you guys soon next week on video again. All right, bye.